So I have an example VM here that is using ephemeral disk, and do you notice anything missing? That's right, there is no disk. That means just like the temporary disks that are assigned to each of your VMs, the ephemeral disk comes from the physical host that the VM is running on. When you reset the VM, you deallocate it, you reprovision it, that temporary storage will go away because it's tied to the physical host that you're running on. Ephemeral disks function the same way. If the VM is running and rebooted, you're fine. But if you then go and deallocate or reprovision or resize, then you're gonna end up on a different host and your VM will essentially reset back to the base image and you gotta start over. So the way that we're gonna have to work with these ephemeral disk systems is a custom image that has everything that we need already baked in. And a great use case for this is going to be Windows Virtual Desktop. So I've logged on to our stateless VM and you can see in the background that I've got the Internet Explorer running. And in the File Explorer, I've created a temp directory on the C drive and I've downloaded some programs, one of them being the new Edge browser. So I'll close the Internet Explorer and just kick off the installer for Edge. And we were able to install the browser on our system just fine. Now I'm going to reboot the VM without deallocating it. We'll just do a normal restart and let's see what happens. And when we log back in, the new Edge browser is still here and we can access it. But now watch what happens. I'll sign out of the VM. And in Azure, I'll click on the VM. Now notice that the stop button is grayed out. Okay, we cannot deallocate this VM. Okay, we can either delete it or we can reimage it. And if we reimage it, it'll reset back to the foundational image that we built it from. So instead, what I'm gonna do is do a resize. And I'll resize this to a DS3V2. And our size shows that our VM has reset correctly. So if we log back in, and the new Edge browser is gone. We're back to the old IE and my ctemp directory is gone. The VM has been completely reset to the base image. All right, so again, the use case is as long as you can keep your VM up and running and just take normal reboots, then you should be just fine and you can keep it operating. But then once the VM deallocates, the system will reset back to the base image. Now that we understand the concepts of using ephemeral disk, we're going to make ourselves a stateless VM for WVD. Now I've already got an image for this from our last video. I'll search for images. Here's my image that's prepped and ready to go. And I built this without anything special for ephemeral disk. I'll just click on it, we'll go to create a new VM from it, and we'll just call this stateless one. It's already got the image pre-selected. We'll scroll down. I've selected DS3V2 as our size, since that supports ephemeral disk, and I put in my credentials. We'll hit next, and we'll hit the drop-down for the advanced here and switch our ephemeral disk to yes. And in this case, I'm not going to add another data disk like I had mentioned or other kinds of workloads because in WVD, everything the system needs to run, including my applications, are already inside the image. The user's data is going to be stored with FS Logix. Therefore, I don't need an extra data disk. We'll click next for the networking and I've set this to use my existing WVD network. We'll hit next for management and I've selected my storage account for boot diagnostics. And when I scroll down, the setting that I usually have on my VMs for auto shutdown, we will not be using since, again, we cannot stop this VM without resetting it. And this brings up a good point is that if you are using ephemeral disk for your systems, they will be running 24/7 because if you deallocate them, they will effectively reset. You'd have to rejoin the host pool, rejoin the domain. Now, with that kind of caveat, why would you want to use this for WVD? Well, ephemeral disk running off of the local physical host that it's attached to will have a much faster OS disk than you would with remote storage. It's just the laws of physics. The other thing that this can buy you is a faster rollover cycle in your fleet to increase your security and patch levels much more frequently. Generally in the cloud, we turn off VMs we don't need to save money. And you can still do that process with these stateless VMs. When you turn them on, they will come right from your image. That means they'll always have your latest version of patches and software and security fixes, because everything is packed into your image and your data for your users are stored in FS Logix on remote file storage. The system is effectively stateless, So I've added some tags for this build, and we can keep track of our cost center, that this is part of the WVD application, this is my lab environment, and this is a stateless tiered VM. So I'll click next for the review, and before we hit create, we'll click the download template for automation link. So if I start off on the parameters tab and scroll down just a little bit, here on line 26, the ephemeral disk type has a value of local. Let me show you where that plugs into the template. Click the VM on the left, and we'll scroll down to the storage profile. And you can see there's a property type here called diff disk setting with an option. And that is pulling from that same parameter we just looked at. So the option value here is local. So the only two things that you need to make it an ephemeral disk is make sure that the VM SKU that you're using is compatible, and then put in that diff disk setting with the option of local. And in this case, on line 99 and 100, you can see that I'm using an image reference, which is my custom image. This will work on marketplace images just as well. All right, so we'll create this VM. Now with a stateless VM, we can do all the reboots that we need to make it part of our domain and join it to our WVD host pool, but we can't shut the VM off. If we do, everything resets. The only way to make underlying changes is to change the image. So if we wanted, for example, to install a new application, we have to do that in the image and then reprovision our VMs. So let's make it part of our host pool. First thing we need to do is join it to our domain. I'll put in my domain creds, and it has joined successfully. Let's reboot. We need to make this part of our host pool now, so I'll open up my web browser. So I want to go download the WVD agents, and the short link to get there is aka.ms/WVD docs. And over on the left, we'll go under how to, and then we'll open create a host pool and session hosts. And then we'll click this link for PowerShell. And then over on the right, we'll click the link to register a virtual machine. And here we have the WVD agent and the bootloader. So I'll click the links for each of those to download them. Now we're going to need a registration token for our host pool. And inside the WVD web management console at the top, I'll click the plus to add a new session host. And I'll copy my reg key and go back to the VM. And I'll do the WVD agent first. We'll click next, accept the license, hit next, delete the words invalid token and paste our registration key and hit next, and then install. And then we'll click to run our bootloader and we'll just next, accept, next, and install. Now, if you're wondering why could I not just do this with my custom script extension, you're absolutely thinking correctly. Yes, you can, and yes, you should. I'm just showing you the process. We're definitely going to automate this from end to end so that we don't ever have to do something manual again. Now that things are installed, we're going to reboot. And back in the web management console, stateless one has been added into our host pool. And you can see our other two VMs are currently set with a allow new sessions of no. So that means the only VM that we're going to access is going to be our stateless VM. And if I open my RDP app and I'll just go to run my task manager, and opening the details window, we can see my FS Logics profile is loading. And from our task manager, we'll go to file, go to run a new task, open the command prompt, and we'll type the hostname command, and we are on stateless one. And if we go, who am I? We can see we're logged in with our Adam Warlock account. So we just made a stateless VM with ephemeral disk part of our WVD host pool. Now let's kick it up one more notch and do this with full automation. I've gone out to my GitHub repo and we'll go into the WVD repository, into WVD templates and WVD new host. I've got a new template here to provision a VM with ephemeral disk, and we can scroll down a little bit, and I've added a new deploy to Azure button for this. So I'll click that, we'll sign in with our credentials, and it looks like the very same template. So if we scroll down a little bit, we do see that the auto shutdown features are missing. And again, that's because ephemeral disk VMs cannot be shut down, because if they do, they will revert back to their base image. The beauty of doing it this way with full automation is when we provision a VM, it'll already be joined to our domain, joined to our WVD host pool, and have FS Logic set up and configured. Now you can do this, of course, from your custom images, just like we finished building a moment ago. This template, because it is public, I have configured a little bit differently. So if I go in the template to my virtual machine and I scroll down just a little bit to the storage profile, we've got that diff disk setting on line 157 with the option of local, and then the image is referenced on line 161. This is pulling from an Azure Marketplace image for either a Windows Server 2019 with a small disk or the Windows 10 multi-session image, and you can select that when you deploy it. I'll show you that in a second. You can very easily change out this image reference section and put in the image reference ID for your custom image. You can use this in either way. Okay, I'll leave it here as the marketplace image, and you can do that other change if you want to. So I'll close this window and let me just input my parameters real quick. So I'll provision this into my stateless resource group just so we can keep a clear eye on which ones we're deploying. In the end here, we'll get a VM that's named stateless-0. I've got my credentials in here for my admin account as well as my domain name. We're building one VM, and here's where you can choose Windows Server 2019 or Windows 10 multi-session image from our marketplace. And I've got my VNet information here as well as the share for my FSLogix and my registration token. So we'll scroll down, check the box that we agree, and hit purchase. So our stateless VM0 has finished building, and it's been registered automatically as part of our host pool. And I've set all the other VMs to be in drain mode, so the only one we can log on to is our brand new one. And we've got our client open again, and we'll open the task manager, and I'll click the show details. So yep, we've got FSLogix, and there's our task manager. We'll open our command prompt. We are on stateless VM1. So now we've been able to fully automate this, and it's up on my GitHub page, so have fun. I hope you've enjoyed looking at this very cool feature of ephemeral disk turning your VMs into stateless systems. Of course, this isn't what you'd use on every single VM in your environment. It does have specific use cases, so plan that out accordingly. And if you thought that this video was good or you learned something new, go ahead and hit that thumbs up button. And while you're down there, feel free to share this video with anybody else you think might find it interesting. And if you haven't done so already, go ahead and click the subscribe button. Join us here at the Azure Academy community, where we are just trying to help everybody learn all they can about Azure. And if you have a comment about this video or a question about just about anything in Azure, if I don't know, I probably know someone who does, go ahead and leave that for me in the comment field down below, and we'll get you an answer as soon as possible. We've got a lot more things in the works here at the Azure Academy, so check back frequently. We do put out a new video roughly once a week. And if you're interested in checking out something else over here on the top, we've got our latest video, as well as on the bottom, a video that we picked out specially for you. And again, I hope that you've enjoyed today's video, and we will see you in the next one. Happy learning.